Greetings, everyone, and welcome back. We are on Cursed. We're about to get back into grinding up our level 1 missions. But first, I have made a discovery. Apparently, our unallocated skill points, even if they're unallocated, still count towards your 5 mil training. So if we hit, 4,700,000, or close to it, we're actually going to stop training because we're sitting on these 324,000 skill points. So we're going to go ahead and use them. And I did some thinking, I'm trying to figure out, because we're going to get into level 2 missions pretty quickly. I wanted to see how fast we can get into our cruiser and get that all set up. So I've adjusted my skill plan to get us drones 5, so we can fly 5 light drones, because we're going to need those to help deal with frigates in the level 2, 3, 4 missions as we get there. Because battlecruisers, battleships are progressively worse at shooting frigates. So I've set it up, and we're going to train right into our cruiser, make sure we have the skills for cruisers, drones, and medium turrets pretty quick. However, I made a mistake. In my hurry to try to get everything set up before the recording, I bought my cruiser and medium turret skill books right here. Bought them in this system right here, Coriti. I'm going to go ahead and set destination. It's only 3 jumps away, it looks good. They were nice and cheap. And then bottom without thinking. And there's 2 jumps into low sec. So now we have a dilemma, and I sort of wanted to talk through it here. We've got about 600,000 ISK worth of skill books, which isn't a lot. It's under 1 million. We're sitting in a $3 million ship, a 3 million ISK ship with about 60 million worth of implants in our clone. So we have 2 options. We have a few options. One, we can just fly out there and hope we don't die and get the books. I'm not going to do that. I'm not going to risk 70 million worth of stuff to do that. We could trade our ship out for a starter ship, a Reaper, and just fly out there. We probably won't lose our clone, but we could. All it takes is 1 smart bomb in the wrong spot, and our clone's dead. That's happened to me before. So we'd still be risking our implants. The other thing we could do is get our jump clone set up so we could jump to an empty clone, fly out there, come back, jump into our clone. That way we don't risk pretty much anything. The skill book for that, let me just get in here. It's under neural. I can never find neural enhancement. We need infomorph technology. It's 1 million ISK, so it's worth more than rebuying the books we need. And I really don't need clones at the moment. Takes out of our training queue, not much, like a few minutes. And is in the same place. All of these are low sec gated. So we can't actually get to them from here without going through low sec. So I think the best course of action is to fly back in towards Dodixi, rebuy the skill books, because it's still cheaper than doing this one, injecting them there, and training the skills when we get back. Okay, so what I'm going to do is here. This is the... to here covers a chunk of our ISK. We really need drones 5, and it's a 3-day train, so what I think I'm going to do is use the rest of it to take a fair chunk out of that. It's going to be 415, so we'll be just under by about, 100,000 skill points. So it'll be a couple days to get that trained up. It's 25,000 a day for an alpha skill points. So it's like 4 days, 3 days. Yeah, whatever it is. There we go. So that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna train these using our skill points. That'll get us almost all the way to drone fives. And then we're just gonna continue down the chain. These may not be in the order they stay in. I kind of just shuffled things around to get into the cruiser with drones. We won't need medium drones so much because we're gonna rely on our guns, but we need these probably warriors to help take out the frigates, especially once we get to level 3s in our battle cruiser, which we will get to. But yeah, so that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna go over, I'm gonna find a place in high sec to buy these skill books, and we're gonna inject them, and then we're gonna use our skill points. We'll play around with that. I haven't actually done the injecting as an alpha, so I'll see what that's gonna entail and how much work that is. Once we have all that done and we're back to training, we're going to run some missions. But first, let me go find some skill books that aren't in low sec and aren't going to cost 5 million apiece. All right, we are back in Somelia with our skill books. I had to go 10 jumps away to find them, but we got it done. While I was there, I picked up some other ones we're going to need in the future just so I don't have to make that trip again. I think the only ones I didn't get are like the drone and various turret specializations. So I even picked up like the large turrets and all that. So we won't have to do that trip again for a while. We can focus on grinding up. Let's go ahead and start applying some of these skill points. We'll see how this works on this, because usually I just apply it to the queue, but you can only queue it up for like a day at a time. So let's just start with medium projectile turrets one. So I can show you here, we got skill plan. We're just gonna go down the list. Can you see both? We can. So gunnery, medium projectile, let's go with my skills. So you can see I have like large projectile turret ready to go. And let's do apply skill points. Set a number between that and that. Well, we don't want to go all the way to the end. So I guess let's do 750 to get us to level 1. And we're going to have to do this one at a time, eh? All right. 3493. I mean, I guess I could do the math and see how much it takes, but we'll just do it this way. And we want to get that to 3. And you guys see what I'm doing? It's really simple. Right click, apply skill points. Right here. Tells you how much you need to get to the next level. And we're just going to go to that number. Boom. So I'm just going to go through our list here. Down the list. We should get all the way down to about here, and we'll apply the leftover points to Drome 5 just to shave some time off, and we'll see what we're left with at the end. All right, there we go. We've got our queue all up. Projectiles, cruisers, and drones. We've got 3 more days on Drones 5, which is fine. We will get that done, and then we can queue up the rest of our skills and just keep training as we are. But we are now capable of flying our Rupture once we get there. So let's go start grinding up some level 1 missions, and we'll see where we go from there. We'll see what this guy has for us. I'm not going to bother looking up the missions. I'm just going to run them. So I don't think the level ones really matter. Oh yeah, we still have this cargo delivery. Fine. I was going to do that off camera. We'll do it now. Okay, here we are in system. We just have to warp to the site. You have to collect the item from a warehouse and bring it home. So I'm not sure if we'll have to kill stuff before we open the warehouse. That might be the case. I'm hoping that's the case because I like shooting. And we'll see how this guy does in level one missions. Just gonna land on grid here and see what we're up against. There's the warehouse, 40 kilometers away. Take us a minute to close the gap. Probably do this in double speed. And that's that. Just turn out and we run away. Oh no, I bounced! Don't bounce, don't bounce, don't bounce. Jump. Oh, okay. That was very well done. There you go. Alright, end in this mission. Get 46, 170,000 worth, basically, if you include LP. Complete. Sweet. And we are going to do eliminate the pirate campers. Perfect. Shooting mission. Eliminate the Serpentis ships. So we actually, did we want to do kinetic thermal against Serpentis? So we will switch to, yeah, we'll switch to the phased plasma for this mission. And we get some stuff. Let's do it. It is in the next door system, so we'll warp over there and bring you guys back once we are on grid. All right, here we go. We are warping in. Warping in, warping in. About to land on grid, and we will start wiping out the pirates. Let's see how our new fit works out. Yep, looks like we have a newcomer, boys. That's fine. Afterburner on. And we'll split our guns up, and we should be able to wipe them out real fast. They counted for some more agency points, too. It's beautiful. And that's the mission. Back we go. All right, hand in this mission. So it actually takes longer to travel to the sites than it does to finish them right now, which is good, because it's going to mean these are going to go quick. So we can just get on grid and wipe them out. And we'll just watch for this to turn white. I think it should. Once we have effective standing at 2, he should open this up for us, so it should open a little early, I think. We can always check that. Probably after this next mission or two. But let's go ahead and request a mission and see what we get. Hidden stash. Destroy the warehouse and retrieve the sealed containers, eliminate the pirate threat, and then return to your agent with the goods. Oh, perfect. And it's in this system, so there'll be no real travel time. 150. We can carry that. Let's go. Oops, I gotta... There we go. So we'll go do that. Wipe out the threats, kill the warehouse, grab the goods. Oh, this one's behind a gate. Adds a little bit of travel time, but that's okay. Jump, 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 jump. I don't know who we're fighting, but let's go back to our... whichever ammo we have the most of. Phased plasma. So we'll use that unless it's Angel. We'll switch if we need to. Oops, Corpy. Yeah, these are Angel. So we'll get Fusion in here. Close distance on the last guy. Do a keep it range. And we'll shoot once we're close. And here we go. Shoot the first guy, shoot the second guy, shoot the third guy. And then we'll wait. We'll shoot this guy. We'll just start sort of piling the guns on him. Okay, then we find the warehouse. So that'll be under here. Warehouse. We're going to orbit the warehouse. Barely took any damage. We'll pulse our repper just because we have it. And 1, 2, 3. Nice and quick. Open this. There's the loot. Open this one, see what's in it. Sure. I could use some dairy products. Oh, never mind. Not worth very much anyway. We will go dock at our station and hand this mission in, and then we'll pick up another one. I want to try to get to level 2 missions as quick as possible. Be nice if I can do it today in this video. So we'll see what happens. Interesting. So yeah, this is going a lot quicker than I remember, but again, last time I did it all in a frigate, so it was chasing each ship down and killing it one at a time, basically. So definitely worth the investment in the destroyer as far as speed is concerned. I think the cruiser, because a lot of the time is still in travel, a cruiser would actually slow me down right now because I'd spend more time traveling than I do in the destroyer. But we'll definitely want to go to the cruiser for level 2s. So let's hand this in and see what we get. Effective standing 2.1. I doubt this guy's going to talk to us, right? No, we got to get his effective standing up. So yeah. Good enough. How close are we? Request mission. Are we getting close? No. All right. So here we go. We're going to double time. We're going to grind up a bunch of missions. Blood Raider spies. Kill them all. Here we go. See you on grid. All right. Hitting the acceleration gate. About to land on grid. We have Blood Raiders to wipe out. So you can see we're getting a wide variety. We had Angel, we have Blood Raiders. These ones actually... Yeah, I mean, it's Serpentis. So it was good that we Omni-tanked. I think that's going to pay off in the end. Let's get started on getting to these guys. Go, go, go. They're very far away. They are very, very far away. Come close the gap, my friends. That's right. Oh, I have more than one group. There's a group above me, too? Oh, a group below me. Beautiful. Start shooting you. In fact, let's just wipe you out. Boom. 1, 2. I'll put 3 on you. Gotta get within 31 kilometers to target these guys. So we'll just sort of kill these guys as we're going. Ooh, tracking disruption, eh? Not saving you. Actually, it is doing pretty good. I'm too far away. Close range on you. I thought you'd be faster. Crucifier. Stop the gun since we're missing. We don't want to waste the ammo. Get within range. Pow, pow, pow. There we go. Closing the distance. Start targeting the folks. And we have to get within about, I figure about 7. Yeah, 7. Kind of start pulling the trigger around 9-ish, but... Since you're the only one, we'll wipe you out. And we'll get guns on you, and you, and you. And we'll keep at range on you. Switch the guns, switch the guns. There we have it. So I will get us back to our station, we'll cut out the travel time, and in this mission, and keep grinding. Alright. Docked up. Handing in the mission. What is next? We are getting some points now. Mordu's Headhunters. Now we have to kill some Mordu's Angel, or Mordu's Legion. Alright. Same system. Set destination, accept the mission. Undock. And we will see you on grid. This is the grind. Back and forth, back and forth. Alright. Landing on grid. Looks like there's a gate too, so... I don't think we can activate it yet. It's probably locked. Yep. Must kill these guys. So what a lot of people do, and we would speed this up, because we do spend more time traveling than actually running the missions at level 1. If you're going to find something other than Sisters, you can try to find a spot that has multiple level 1 agents in an area, pick up all the missions for all the agents, and then go run them, and then go hand them in. Can speed things up a little bit, but I'm hoping this gives a feel for, you know, how long it takes to grind up to level 4 missions. That's kind of the whole point of this series, is to show let's turn the afterburner on, to show Eve how I play it and as I see it. Now, you can go straight into PvP and low sec and have quote-unquote action every day, but there is always a lot of build-up. You're gathering supplies, you're fitting ships, you're getting them in position. So you see a lot of videos of the actual action, but you don't see a lot of what happens to get the player into that action and what that takes. Right? And that's what I'm kind of trying to get through here is that's the game. That's the part of the game I like. It's not just jump in and play all the time. You can get it set up that way, but there's still work even to get it set up to just jump in and play. You have to find a group of people. You have to get your assets where you need them. So, you know, fusion, that's fine. Oh, no. Yeah, that's fine. We'll just use fusion. It's already in there. We're going to bounce off this asteroid. Nope, we're just going to fly right through it. That's fine. There's the bump. So manual piloting can help with stuff like that. We'll get through this gate. There we go. We should probably have turned this off. But yeah, so this is basically what being a mission runner in EVE is. PvP can be a lot more exciting, and a lot of times, and I do say this, is I'll play PvP on my main on Cal through Faction Warfare and do this in my downtime when I can't be fully engaged. As a stay-at-home homeschooling dad, a lot of days I have to have my attention split at the very least, if not focused on my kids. Very split. So this is something I can do, especially when you get to level 4, as they become a little more, how I run them anyway, they're pretty relaxed. You just keep distance and shoot things, right? So this is Eve. It's just grinding missions. It becomes a pretty decent source of income too if you can't focus enough to do your ratting and null sec or anything like that. Again, which I have problems with most days. Can't be watching local as much as I should be, and I've been caught a couple times because I was distracted. So doing this is a relatively safe way to run missions. Now that should be done unless I have to grab something, so let's see what the details say. Make sure you leave no survivors. So it should be done. Something's going to pop in on us here in a minute. Another gate? No. No, we should be done. Let's see what he says. Destroy them all. Okay, so why isn't it checking it off for me? I will have to check on my website, make sure I didn't miss something. And we'll just bring that up here real quick. Oops. And this is called Mordu's Headhunters. Nothing new on grid. I'll just scroll down to M. I'll get there first. Mordu's Headhunters, level 1. Oh yeah, so we're going to get a spawn, it looks like. Group 1, group 2, group 3. So where are they? Yeah, there they are. Just showed up on grid, so we will go take care of it. So we'll have to wait for the spawns because we kill them too fast. Looks like they're maybe giving time for newer players to not get overrun by spawns, and that's fine. This means we will have to wait. He's shooting at me. Come on now. Fire him up. He's taking a good little beating in his armor. Let's take a look. It's a really cool ship. I love the look of them. Kind of shark-like. Super cool. Let's get down to him. Where is he? He's down there. We don't want to bump into the station, so I'm just going to manually pilot this direction a bit and close the gap on them and light them up. 10, 9, 8. We can start firing here. Listen to the guns. Yeah. So it's just a fun little relaxing time. I really, really do enjoy it. I'm not lying. I enjoy running missions. Especially, you know, I've got the kids doing math work next to me and I can look away from the screen and not worry too much about dying. It's good stuff. It's very good stuff. And then when I do have time to focus and I'm not recording, I jump in on my other guy and either do some PvP in Faction Warfare or I jump on Pockets and run some high-sec stuff with the Corp. Alright, back in station. We're going to hand in this mission. This will be the last one for the day, so let's see what happens. Beautiful. Some more points. We're getting close to being able to have a turn-in. Just to see. Just to see. Show affordable. Oh, let's just do a search for probe. No, we're like halfway there. Excellent. So that'll be the last mission for this video. We're going to call it a day here. I think I'm going to grind up the rest of the level ones off camera. I'll do those in my free time. Just, you've seen it. You know what it entails. Let's grind them up. Let's get ourselves up to our next ship. It's going to take me a few days to do that, probably due to time this weekend. But we'll get that done and we'll get on to our cruiser. I may try to live stream it. We'll see how my schedule looks. But other than that, when we come back, we should be there. Something interesting happened, like the new event, or I did something with Malro on Pockets. But as far as Kirst is concerned, I will bring him back when he's on cruisers. You guys don't want to sit here through this tedium. I do spend more time flying to the mission sites than I do running them. And so I want to get through it and get to some level 2s and level 3s where we'll spend more time on grid and actually playing the game. So I hope you enjoyed the video. If you have any comments, don't forget to put them down below. If you like the video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. And if you're new and you haven't, don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss the next bunch of videos. Take care of each other, and I'm out of here.